ahead and move into the next round, the next little thing. The Los Angeles Rams, their over-under right now is 8.5, according to Vegas odds. They needed offensive line help, linebacker help, and running back help. Look, they didn't have a first-round pick. They traded that away to get the cornerback out of Jacksonville. But they did have 2 second-round picks. They had 2 third-round picks. They had a 4th, a 6th, and 3 in the 7th. So you can always find a way to get draft picks if you need them. And Los Angeles definitely needed them. They did not have a lot of capital. They don't have a lot of free agency cap room. So this was how they were going to be able to replenish their roster. And I, you know, let's, how about this? I'll roll through all of them real quick, and then we'll jump into it. Round 2, number 52 pick, they got running back Cam Akers out of Florida State. Round 2, number 57, they got wide receiver Van Jefferson out of Florida. Round 3, 84th, they got edge rusher Terrell Lewis out of Alabama. Number 104 in the 3rd round, they got safety Terrell Burgess out of Utah. Obviously a big fan of that pick. Round 4, tight end Bryson Hopkins out of Purdue. Round 6, they got safety Jordan Fuller out of Ohio State. Round 7, they got 3 picks. Linebacker Clay Johnston out of Baylor. Kicker Sam Sloman out of Miami of Ohio. And offensive tackle, Tremaine Ankrum out of Clemson. Okay, so let's grade their first round pick as Jalen Ramsey. I think that's good. I mean, if you can trade a pick to get Jalen Ramsey, somebody that's established and whatnot, okay. You're still gonna have to
trade. Yeah, now you got to pay him or he's gone. So you traded a first round pick for a guy that's going to be on your team for 2 years. Congratulations.
Or you got to pay him, right?
Or you got to pay him, but they have no cap room.
So yeah, running back Cam Akers and wide receiver Van Jefferson, Florida State and Florida, both in the 2nd round. Van Jefferson, I think they reached a little bit on. I was incredibly surprised that they took him as early as they did. But they must have been super sold on him, and who am I to judge Sean McVay on offensive talent, right? Cam Akers, I was a little bit shocked that he fell all the way to 52. The kid is an absolute – he is the only reason that Florida State was able to go to a bowl game last year. He was their offense for 2 years running. The kid is unbelievable.
This is not a knock on Cam. I like Cam a lot. For a team that has very little draft capital this year, next year, and the following year, and no cap space at all to sign anybody, running back is not a position I would be drafting.
Maybe not that early.
You drafted one last year in the 3rd round that everyone thought was going to be the heir apparent to Todd Gurley. I know you had him in your class for a year, the boy from Memphis, but like, are you done with him or not? Because why are you spending draft capital on a guy that you need other positions, and you're going to have to fill this roster at some point in time?
Yes. Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
And you have no money, and you don't really have any premium picks.
Yeah.
I'm not taking it, but you know how I feel about running back.
No, I totally understand.
The very first pick in the draft. I don't care where it falls. The fact that it was late in the 2nd round is your fault.
Yes. 3rd round, edge rusher Terrell Lewis out of Alabama and safety Terrell Burgess out of Utah. I like both of these picks. Terrell Lewis, when healthy, that's the biggest caveat here, when he's healthy, is an absolute monster on the edge. He can get to the quarterback better than anybody that was on Alabama's team over the last 2 seasons. He helped win. Like, he was the biggest reason they won the national championship in 2017. You know, it just depends on whether or not he's healthy. Now, he played all of last season. He missed almost 2 full seasons before that. That's where the issue comes in. He's a 3rd-round guy, I think mainly because of injury, and you don't know whether or not you can count on him to be healthy. But if he's healthy, he's got a high motor. He can get in there. Like, he missed 1 season due to a fluke bicep tear or whatever it was, and then the next year was like a pectoral tear. Like, it just crazy random stuff that you don't know whether it's going to be long-term or not. Now, obviously, he came back last year, had a monster season at Alabama. I mean, it led the team in sacks, like all this different kind of stuff. So I think Terrell Lewis can be really, really good. Terrell Burgess, safety out of Utah, phenomenal pick. You know, you and I both love safeties in today's NFL defenses, right? It is an incredibly underappreciated position because they dictate how the defense works. If you're the Rams, you need defensive help. I mean, the Bucks came in and hung 55 on you last year in your house. Like, you need some defensive help, especially going against the offenses in the rest of this division. I think this was a really, really good pick, and they got some value with this one. I think Burgess is phenomenal. He made plays all over the field for Utah. He is great in run support. He is great in coverage. The guy is a little bit undersized, but I think he's going to be fantastic. I like Terrell Burgess a ton. Round four, Bryson Hopkins out of Purdue. Stereotypical, big, you know, bulky tight end that can catch the ball if you need him to, but he can be used more as a blocker. So if you're going to try and utilize Cam Akers and Darrell Henderson's speed and athleticism, you're going to use that guy a lot. So I like that pick. You got safety Jordan Fuller out of Ohio State. I don't think he's as good as Terrell Burgess, but still good safety out of Ohio State. And then your seventh round flyers, all from really well-coached teams, Miami of Ohio, Baylor, and Clemson, all teams that won their division, all teams that won their conference. You got linebacker Clay Johnston out of Baylor, kicker Sam Sloman, who was actually really good. Like, you know me, I bet on Miami of Ohio a lot last year. Not a lot, multiple times. So I did actually watch Miami of Ohio multiple times last year. And then offensive tackle Tremaine Ankrum out of Clemson. You know, these are all good guys to take flyers on from pick 234 through 250. I don't know that they're going to be great. I don't know that they're even going to be good. But they're seventh-round picks. I like what the Rams did in the draft, especially later. I don't like the idea of taking a running back with your first pick early in the second round. And Van Jefferson, you know, seemed like a bit of a reach for a wide receiver late in the second round. But rounds three through seven, like, I think it was totally fine. So I'll say that I like what they did.
I like Cam Akers a lot, a whole lot. I don't know that that's the place where you want to be taking somebody right there where you have a lot of other needs, I believe, that you're going to have to fill. Maybe not this year, but in the coming years. I just wasn't impressed.
I can understand it.
This was one of the teams that I didn't think did a good job. You don't have a lot of draft capital, and I didn't think they spent it well. And I think you're going to have a lot of guys coming up in free agency soon that you're either going to let go or pay out the nose for, but you got to hope they can stay healthy and keep producing. Yeah. I think this team went all in on winning a Super Bowl early. And when they didn't, I think they're going to struggle the next couple of years fielding a real competitive team with depth. The next couple of years, they've got plenty of guys signed as stars. The problem is they don't have anybody behind those guys.
Yeah. Yeah. The depth is going to be an issue. And I think that's why your flyers on those guys in the sixth, seventh rounds, that's why you take them, right? You just hope to God that you can develop them enough that they are useful NFL players. Let's